Hello everyone, so this is my second video on sex determination from evolution and heredity chapter 9 NCERT class 10 book. So this is my second video on sex determination. So firstly I will tell about the how the sex is determined in an organisms or human being or any other animals which are found in our globe. So first thing, we'll see that there are different approaches to determine the sex in different organisms. So out of which those approaches, one approach is this in some organisms or animals, those are temperature dependent sex determination organisms, means those organisms which depend upon the temperature for the determination of their offspring, whether they are male or female. Means in those organisms who are dependent upon the temperature for the determination, okay, for the determination of male and female in their offspring, and this temperature will play a vital role in their zygote formation or a embryonic cell formation during their sexual reproduction in those organisms who are dependent on the temperature. So a specific amount of temperature is needed during the zygote formation in those organisms like reptiles who are dependent upon temperature, and this temperature will decide whether their offspring will be male or a female in those temperature dependent organisms such as reptiles. So second is that snail can change sex. Snail are also called slipper limpets, SLIPPER, slipper, and limpets, LLIMPET, limpet, slipper limpet, the spelling of slipper limpet. Snail can change sex because they are slipper limpets, and when the snail is birth, they are born as male, and they can change their gender in their life cycle into female. It means that snail can experience both sexes, whether it will be male or a female, they can experience in their life cycle. Thirdly, in case of human, it is totally different. There is no any dependent upon temperature or no changes in sexes in human being. In human being, sex is genetically determined from the genes or a chromosome, same thing only, and gene inherited from parents will determine sex. Yeah, and those genes which are inherited from our parents during the sexual reproduction will determine our sex. This is a very important point. Gene inherited from parents will determine sex in case of human being. There are 23 pair of chromosome. There are 23 pair of chromosome in human being. Means totally 46 chromosome are found. 46 chromosome are found. Out of which 22 pair are autosomes. 22 pairs are autosomes, and one pair is sex chromosomes. And these 22 pair of autosomes will not decide whether the offspring will be male or a female. The main element to determine the male and female offspring in a human being is the sex chromosome. This is the game changer. Will determine whether the male or a female in a human being. So basically the sex chromosome consists of what? One is for male and another is for female. XY. For male it is XY, means one X allele and one Y allele. And this XY is not perfectly matched, so this is mismatch pair male. And in case of female, XX, both X allele. So perfectly pair female. This is the nomenclature of the male and female. So secondly, how we determine this sex in human being. So for this we have to know some mechanisms, we have to know some examples how this process is done to determine whether the offspring will be male or a female. So when there is a crosses between the XY and XX, XY means male and XX means female, this XY means male and XX means female. When there is cross between the XX and XY, so suppose we taken this XY from the suppose we've taken that X and Y alleles, which are alleles of the male chromosome XY chromosome, and this XX alleles from the female chromosome XX chromosome. Suppose this is parent crossing over taken between the parent. when these four alleles are involved in crossing over, suppose this X is crossed with this X, means the X alleles of XY chromosome is crossed with the X allele of XX chromosome, there is a formation of XX, means female or daughter, female. So whenever there will be a cross between the Y allele, this Y allele of male with the X allele of female, then there is formation of XY, and XY means what? Male. XY means what? Male. And these are the offspring resulted from those parents. But there will be always 50% chance of getting male or female from those parents. 50% chance, whether means there is only 50% probability or half probability of getting male or female. This is for male and this is for female. So offspring must inherit X chromosome from mother. This is very important line. Whenever there will be a cross between the XX female and male, XX female and XY male, during the crosses between these four XY and XX four alleles, there is the always involvement of mother. If not, there will be involvement of Y allele, but there will be involvement of X allele compulsory, whether it will be son or a daughter, no matter, there is always involvement of X, but Y is not compulsory to be involved in those crosses. Whether it will be daughter, then XX, whether it will be son, then XY, means X is needed in both cases. X is required in both cases. So mother will play a great role in the crossing over between the male and female. So without X, there is no product. We should means there is a must requirement of the X allele. Sex of a child is determined what they inherit from father. So mainly the father is a game changer in this matter. If the X chromosome is taken from the father, then it is definitely a what? Daughter. The formation of daughter. Definitely a formation of daughter. And if the Y allele is taken from the father, XY, Y allele is taken, then it is definitely XY formation, means male. So the sex of a child is totally determined when what they inherit from father, means father means the sex of an offspring is totally dependent upon the father, what the father will provide
means which allele he will provide, whether he will provide X allele or a Y allele, it depends upon the father. So whenever the father will provide X allele, then no doubt it will be what, daughter. And if the father will provide Y allele, then it is always son or a male. Totally depend upon the father, because female is already X and X. Okay, there is no any involvement of the Y allele. So only the father will determine whether their offspring will be a son or a daughter, whether their offspring will be a beta or betty, same like. So father is a game changer. So this is the concept behind the sex determination in human being. So if you like my video, please subscribe my channel for the next video, and I am going to uploading the next video on evolution. What is evolution? This is basically, this video is for the class 10 students who are unable to go to schools and their respective institution due to the lockdown in entire country to fight against the coronavirus. So this is my little efforts towards them. So hope you guys like this video. So stay safe and stay home. Thank you. Bye.